thank everybody coming out today for the Pontoon Beach Police Department. State Attorney is going to talk here shortly about the charges that were filed against the suspect in this case. I will only be talking about Mr. Timmins and his family and what he's done for our department and the community. Everything else I'll refer to Illinois State Police and to the Madison County State's Attorney's Office, reference to the case, since it's still an ongoing case. My name is Chris Madrusik. I'm the Chief of Police with Pontoon Beach. First of all, I'd like to extend my deepest condolences to Officer Timmins' wife, Lindsay, his daughter, Chloe, and the entire Timmins family. Just Monday, Tyler came into my office asking to switch his schedule around because him and Lindsay had their Timmins family Christmas on New Year's Eve. And it was important to him, right before he left the station Tuesday morning, he left telling a story about his daughter, Chloe. Lindsay, Chloe, and his family were everything to Tyler, and everyone who knew him knew that. A close second to him was his job. Tyler truly loved being a cop. He loved his job, he loved his department, and everyone on the department. In a day where most are running from the law enforcement, he still took pride in his job every single day. There is no greater love than a man who lays down his life for a stranger. Yesterday, Officer Timmins paid the ultimate sacrifice. As devastating as this loss is to his family, us, and this entire law enforcement community, I truly believe if Tyler could tell us anything, he would tell us all he didn't die for nothing. He died doing exactly what he loved, protecting and serving this community and the surrounding communities. October 26th will be a day the Pontoon Beach will always remember. We will carry it with us forever. We will use our grief and sorrow to honor Tyler's memory. His legacy will live on through every one of us, every single time we put our uniforms on. On behalf of myself, Major Chardon, Mayor Mike Pagano, and the entire Pontoon Beach Police Department, I'd like to extend my utmost gratitude to everyone who stepped in to help us and the Timmins family. Your love, the outpouring support we have received, has kept us all going through this difficult time. And there's truly no amount of words that can express our gratitude. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you to Pontoon Beach, Chief, the Police Department, our condolences to you, the men and women of Pontoon Beach especially. It's a terrible, terrible day yesterday, and it continues to be a terrible day today. But at least now the work of justice begins. This afternoon, the Madison County State's Attorney's Office charged Scott Hyden, 31, of Highland, Illinois, with two counts of first-degree murder, one count of aggravated discharge of a firearm at a peace officer, one count of unlawful possession of weapons by a felon, one count of unlawful possession of a stolen firearm, and one count of offenses relating to motor vehicles in yesterday's shooting death of Pontoon Beach police officer Tyler Timmins. The two counts of first-degree murder are on alternative theories. The maximum sentence available under law for these offenses is natural life. And let me be very clear, we will absolutely be seeking the maximum sentence under law in this case. Our police are heroes. Violent attacks on police are absolutely unacceptable in our community. Those who attack police officers, the men and women behind us here today who have dedicated their lives to protecting us all from harm will be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law in Madison County. Officer Tyler Timmins dedicated his life to serving and protecting the citizens of Madison County. We all thank him and thank his family for his incredible, heroic life. We are all grateful for the service of all the first responders who put their lives on the line for our safety every day. So please join me in keeping the family, friends, and colleagues of Officer Timmins in your prayers today and in the future. Thank you especially to the Illinois State Police for their excellent work in solving this terrible crime in a quick and professional manner, and the Sheriff's Department for their wonderful support throughout this trying ordeal for everyone. Thank you. If anyone has any questions.
Our sympathy to everyone. Everybody.
Thank you.
Can you spell the suspect's name? And can you tell us if is he being held without bond and where he is?
Scott T. Hyden, T-Y-D-E-N. Again, as stated, he's 31. He's
spell being that last name again?
Hyden, H-Y-D-E-N. And he's being held in the Madison County Jail with no bond.
Scott with two T's.
Do you have an age for him?
31.
Can you shed any light on the narrative that was shared with us yesterday by the Illinois State Police? It sounds like Officer Timmins just approached this vehicle and Hyden was in it and just started shooting. Is there more to it than that? Or what can you share? What can you tell us about how this happened yesterday?
I would simply say that there's an investigation ongoing. The facts that we intend to prove at trial, not to try the accused in the press, but facts we intend to prove at trial are basically what you just stated, that Officer Timmins approached the vehicle and that the defendant in this case shot Officer Timmins without provocation and that Officer Timmins had no time to even draw his weapon.
What part of the body was
Officer Timmins was shot in the neck.
What kind of gun did he have?
At this time, we won't talk further about evidence, but the basic narrative of the case that we intend to prove at trial is what I just described.
Is he the only person charged at this point? There were some other people taken into custody at the time. I don't know if it's other people or just one person who was with them.
There were two other individuals taken into custody. The investigation is ongoing. It's a very dynamic situation. But I would say at this time, we do not expect further charges relating to the death of Officer Timmins.
Are the other two still in custody, or are they going to be?
They are currently still in custody, yes.
Could you spell your name, please?
My name is Thomas Haine, H-A-I-N-E.
Can you talk about how the suspect was apprehended? We've heard witnesses say that some bystanders jumped in and helped.
I think at this point, we're here to talk about the charges and the basic facts that we intend to prove at trial. I know this is a terrible situation that many people want to know everything about, and I will tell you that those facts will come out at trial, and that's the proper time for those facts to come out. Further information, I would refer you to the Illinois State Police.
At this time, we're not going to be able to answer a lot of your questions pertaining to the crime itself. We do want to thank the community of Pontoon Beach for coming forward and assisting in this investigation. All of the local police agencies, as you see behind me, federal agencies, this is definitely a partnership. And I do offer my deepest condolences to the family of Officer Timmins. It's definitely a hurtful feeling to know that one of our brothers that served with us has given his life. But we, as professionals, we understand we have a job to do. And I thank everyone that we are doing that job. As heavy as it is for us doing it, we're getting it done. Thank you.